day 8 here at the Summer University Games in Gwangju, Korea. A rainy day here in this southern Korean city. Today in the highlights, men's and women's golf tournaments both wrap up. We'll head to the pitch for men's semifinal football action, including a penalty shootout. We have women's semifinal volleyball action. And in athletics, we'll take a look among many other highlights, pole vault and the men's 110 meter hurdles. And a wet and rainy baseball game for the bronze medal here in Gwangju. And finally, mixed doubles tables tennis on the schedule tonight. We head out now to golf, the Naju Gold Lake Country Club outside of Gwangju. This is the men's individual competition. The leader after the third round, Natapong Sritong of Thailand, you see him there. He was 13 under through three rounds. He led after the first, second, and third rounds. Kazuki Higa of Japan was 9 under heading into this fourth and final round. And Nicolas Platret of France was also 9 under. You see them here all teeing off on the 18th hole. Higa had an outstanding final round, going 6 under today to finish at 15 under. Platret too had a great round. You see him putt out there on 18. He was 5 under for the day and 14 under for the tournament. And there you see Higa, his drive on 18. And now his approach. And you almost hole it out. Great approach there by Higa, continuing his strong round, and he putts out, as mentioned, 6 under on the day, 15 under for the tournament. He wins gold. Platret moves into the second spot, wins silver, and Sritong, who led throughout the first three rounds, he will win the bronze medal. Now to the women. Leaders after the third round, Lee Jung-yoon of Korea. She was 7 under after the third round on Friday. Shina Kanazawa of Japan was 6 under, and Peng Che of Chinese Taipei, she was 3 under par. And here you see Kanazawa's approach on 18. And she will sink that putt. She goes 1 over for the day, 5 under for the tournament. That'll put her in second spot. Now you get a look at Lee. As mentioned, 7 under coming into this round on Saturday. And here her approach on 18. And she'll chip that one right close to the cup. She putts out. She goes 2 under today, 9 under for the tournament. That's good enough for a gold medal. Kanazawa will win silver. And at 1 over for the tournament, Sitanart Singanart of Thailand, she will win the bronze. And there you see Lee. And now the final standings here in the women's golf tournament. And there are the medalists, Lee, Kanazawa, and Singanart. It is semifinal Saturday in men's football. First up, Japan takes on Italy. Japan beat France 1-0 in their quarterfinal. Italy beat Ireland 1-0 in theirs. In the early going, Takahashi from distance. And that one just almost beats Niccolo Manfredini of Italy. Now here's Mecchiarello to Detsi, but stopped there by Mikawa. Now into the second half, there's Shigehiro. The great shot stopped by Manfredini. And after full time, it'll be 0-0. We will head off to a shootout. First up, Masato Yuzawa of Japan off the bar, and a miss for the Japanese. Japanese again, this one stopped by Manfredini. Italy would score in their first two attempts, and there Daniel Cappelletti, he'll score in their third. So Arai has to score, but he cannot beat Manfredini. And Italy off to the gold medal match. They will seek their second gold ever in Universiade history. Second semifinal, Brazil and Korea. Here's Lee Hyun-sung. He'll fire just wide. Korea beat Uruguay 3-0 in their quarterfinal, while Brazil beat South Africa 2-1 in theirs. Korea will get the ball into the box, and a bicycle attempt there by Kim Goon-hee, but it goes over the bar. Here are the fans trying to stay dry on this wet day in Korea. Now to the second half. Lee off the great pass from Joongwon Jin. He'll get that one deflected, pass to Shara Martens. And in the 56th minute, Korea would go up 1-0. Great little pass there, and there's the deflection. Korea takes the lead. Now in the 64th minute, there's Moon Joon-ho with the cross. It gets through everybody for Brazil. And Joongwon Jin will score. We'll see it here. As Tashara Martens cannot corral it. And it ends up past him. Korea now up 2-0. And that is how it would end. Korea wins 2-0. They have won previous gold as well from back in 1991. They'll take on Italy for their second. Brazil has yet to win gold. They'll seek their third ever bronze against Japan. There you see inside the Uamju Gymnasium, the site of Brazil and Japan in bronze medal women's volleyball. Here is Mariana Alves to serve. And that one will end up in the net, point Japan. They're up 7-2. Now 15-11, Japan in front. There's a tip by Imamura. Brazil will respond. Good rally here. And there's the kill, Mai Shimizu. Powers it down the middle. And Japan will get to set point here, 24-17. Back set there from Kajima to Inoue. And Brazil and a great dig there by Kojima. And ultimately, Imamura will get that one off the Brazilian block and out. Japan wins the first set. Now later on in the second set, tied at 15. Play at the net, Brazil will recover. Another great rally here. Tip dug up by Brazil. Now Japan comes back the other way, off the Brazilian block. And there's the little tip from Silva, goes off the Japanese block and out. Now to set point for Brazil, 26-25. There's Imamura with the attack, but it's sent back by Ferreira and Jacinto, and we're tied up at one set apiece. Move on now to the fourth set, Japan winning the third, 25-23. Naoko Yutaka serves there, but it can't be returned by the libero Cardoso. 2015, Japan in front. As I've said a few times, yet another good rally here. And that will go off the Japanese block and out for a point Brazil. That's Honorio da Silva. You'll see there just nicks off the fingertips of Shimizu. Match point now. Japan up 24-18. Brazil sets it up for Ferreira, but that one is wide. And Japan wins the bronze medal. 3-1 over Brazil. There you see the score. Japanese bronze medalists. We head back to the Gwangju Universiade main stadium. Athletics competition here on day 8. Slightly inclement weather. The rains came in this afternoon. So all the athletes battling with the showers. Here is Julia Ratcliffe in the women's hammer throw from New Zealand. She won a silver at last year's Commonwealth Games in Glasgow, Scotland. On her third attempt, she throws 67.54 meters. Now Joanna Fiodoro of Poland. She finished 10th at the 2012 Olympics in London and third at last year's European Championships. She gets off a strong throw there. That's 69.69 meters. She would match that again later on her fifth attempt. That would be her best of the day. Now Hannah Skiden of Azerbaijan. This is her fifth attempt. And a strong throw for her. She was already over 70 meters on her fourth attempt. This is 70.67 meters. And that will put her in top spot and win her a gold medal. Fiodoro wins a silver and Ratcliffe claims the bronze. Now the men's 3,000 meter steeplechase final. Patrick Nasty of Italy in this race. He won a bronze in Kazan in 2013. Kaur Kivistik of Estonia. He was fifth at the European Under 23 Championships in 2013. And as if they needed more water, here they come to the water hazard. As you can see, there's water everywhere on the track from the rain. It'll be Christian Grau of Germany, though, pulling away in a season best time of 8 minutes, 31.55 seconds. Kivistik of Estonia will win the silver, and Yuri Klopkov of Russia, the bronze. Off now to the men's 110-meter hurdles. You just saw there Gregmar Swift competed for Barbados at the 2012 Olympics. Also in lane two, Konstantin Shabanov won a silver in this event in 2013. But it is Swift pulling away. Gold medal for Gregmar Swift and Barbados. Shabanov will win his second straight silver medal at Universiade, and Genta Masuno of Japan wins bronze. On now to the men's pole vault. Here's Robert Sobera of Poland. His third attempt at 5.50 meters. And this time he's up and over. Great vault there for the pole. Now Ilya Mudrov of Russia. This is his second attempt at 5.50 meters. And he will get over it fairly easily. Nice vault there for Mudrov. He would fall out at 5.60 meters. Next up, Nikita Filipov won bronze in Kazan at 5.50 meters. Also was fifth at last year's Asian Games. This his first attempt at 5.50. He heads down the runway. He will go up and clear at 5.50. He would make two attempts at 5.6 and one at 5.65. He didn't clear those, so his best mark of 5.50 on his first attempt is enough to give him the gold medal. Mudrov wins silver, and Sobera will take the bronze. And finally for tonight, the women's 5,000 meters. There you see runner 239. That's Christina Mackey of the Czech Republic. And you see there, she'll hold on to win a gold medal in 16 minutes, 3.29 seconds. Camille Buscombe of New Zealand will win the silver, and Daria Maslova of Kyrgyzstan wins bronze. Bronze medal baseball action. The United States taking on Korea. The U.S. lost 8-0 to Japan in their semifinal, and Korea fell 2-0 to Chinese Taipei. Here in the fourth inning, 3-2 the U.S. leading. Korea with one out, two on. And Seo Yale will walk. That'll load the bases. And then a wild pitch uncorked there, and that'll score one, and we're tied at three. Still in the fourth, bases loaded. There's a grounder to Richards, but he just cannot quite handle it. It has been raining, as you can see. Tough play there for Richards to make, looking for the double. Now to the fifth, 7-3 Korea. U.S. with one out, runners on second and third. And Richards will ground out, but that'll score Jared Bravo. Now 7-4 Korea. Now one on, two out. Base hit there for Taylor Bryant. That'll score Tanner Pinkston. U.S. back within two. You get a good close-up look at that swing by Bryant. Now to the sixth, 12-6 Korea leading. One out, one on for Kim Joo-hyun. There's a base hit to the opposite field. Now runners on the corners. Still one out. There's a pass ball allowed by Bravo, and that'll score a run. Korea now up by seven. We'll get a look at it here, just off the top of the glove there of Bravo. We go now to the ninth. Absolutely pouring here in Gwangju. As you can see, they're just trying to get this thing done. 14-6, Korea up. One on, one out. And there is Bravo grounding into the double play in the mud. And you can see the players just laughing a little bit at how crazy the conditions have gotten here. And that'll win Korea a bronze medal. They won silver the two other years Universiade has had baseball. The U.S. has yet to medal in Universiade baseball competition. But in this case here, Korea wins 14 runs on 15 hits and 3 errors. The U.S. 6 runs, 10 hits and 2 errors. We go inside for the gold medal match in table tennis. It's mixed doubles. Korea taking on Chinese Taipei. Kim Min-seok of Korea and Jeon Ji-hee of Korea taking on Chiang Hung-chae and Chen Su-yu. It's a best of seven. We're in the first game. The Koreans are there in the dark uniforms, while Chinese Taipei is in red. Korea would win the first game 11-9. Now we're looking on here in the second. 10-7 right now, the Koreans in front. The Chinese Taipei staying tough here, trying to win this second game. They serve, but it cannot be returned. And Korea will win the second game 11-8. Now at 9-9 in the third game. And that one into the net for Chinese Taipei. Jeon here to serve. And a huge forehand there from her. Korea now with a commanding 3-0 lead. There you'll see this huge forehand from Jeon right down the middle. And Chiang unable to get there. Now into the fourth game. 5-1 right now, Chinese Taipei in front, trying to stay alive. 6-1. With that miss by Jeon, they go up 6-1. Chiang won gold in the men's doubles in 2013 with Huang Shengsheng. So he has experience in these gold medal matches at Universiade. And Jeon for Korea, she won bronze earlier on here in Gwangju in the women's team competition. While Chen and Chinese Taipei, she won silver. Korea though making a bit of a comeback here in this fourth game. That's five straight points for them to tie it up at six. Great return there, as you see from Kim digging to get that one over the net. And Chiang unable to return it. And another point. That's seven straight now for the Koreans, who go up in front 8-6.
7-8.
But the streak is broken there. Now 8-7, and then another miss there from Kim.
8-0.
And we're knotted up again at 8. And a huge forehand yet again from Jeon. Unreturnable from Chinese Taipei. Now 2 points away from gold for Korea. That one long, and we are now at match point. And that one into the net from Chen. And Korea comes back here in this fourth game, and they win this contest 4-0. Chang and Chen will win silver. Chen and Chang of Chinese Taipei win bronze, as do Merzelkin and Noskova of Russia.